Hi, I'm Sanjay Nagchowdhury, Development Lead for the IBM App Connect Enterprise product. In this video, I'll introduce the new Salesforce Input node that was added in IBM App Connect Enterprise version 12.0.6. The Salesforce Input node is one of six new Discovery Connector nodes that were added in 12.0.6. The new nodes have the same look and feel as the previous nodes that were added in 12.0.5. They're all listed in the ACE documentation. We've also provided tutorials for each of these new Discovery Connector nodes. If you open the tutorials gallery and search for Discovery, then you'll see tutorials for the Discovery Connectors from 12.0.5 and the new tutorials that are added in 12.0.6 for the new nodes. So Salesforce is a work management and project tracking application that provides projects, tasks, conversations, and dashboards that enables teams to collaborate and track progress online. So I'm going to create a flow which uses Salesforce Input node, and when a message is received in the flow, it's going to send a message to Slack. Slack is a web-based, real-time, and archived messaging app. You can communicate in open or private channels, send direct messages to colleagues, and share files. So I've previously already shown a video where you can use a Slack request node, but in this video I'm going to show how you can receive a message from Salesforce and then send that to Slack so that a message is sent to a channel. I need to configure my App Connect Enterprise system. So first of all, I'm going to create a test server. So I'm going to specify a vault key. So this will allow a credential vault to be created in the work directory for the integration server. So the test server has been created. And now I'm going to create a policy project, and I'll call it Discovery Policies. And this policy project will contain a policy for describing how to connect to Salesforce using the credentials that are stored in the credential vault, and a separate policy for Slack. So I'm going to right-click on the policy project and select Discovery Connector Policies and Credentials. And I need to specify a work directory. So I'm going to specify the location of a test server. And I need to specify the vault key. And I can check I can access the vault, which I can. And now I can click Finish, and that will open the Connector Discovery Wizard. So first of all, I'll configure the connection details for Salesforce. So I need to specify my username and password. So the password needs to be the password of a Salesforce account, and it needs to be suffixed with the Salesforce security token. Next, I need to specify the client ID, which is the consumer key. And finally, I need to specify the client secret. And I can leave the login URL as it is for my case. So the information on how to configure these connection details are described in the App Connect Enterprise documentation. So you can follow the links for the different nodes, and we have details on how you can configure the connection details for Salesforce. We also have details on how you can configure the details for Slack, which I'm about to do. So I can click Connect. And I've successfully connected. And it lists the events which can start the flow and the actions if I want to use the Salesforce request node. So now I'm going to add connection details for Slack. And for Slack, I need to specify an access token. And I've now successfully connected to Slack. So I've configured my connection details. So now I'm going to create my application and my message flow. So I'm going to call my application Salesforce demo and my message flow, I'll call it new account created. So my message flow is going to be triggered by a Salesforce input node. So I'm going to click on launch connected discovery, specify the policy project, click launch discovery. And I want a flow to be triggered when a new Salesforce account is created. So I can click save and the details are saved to the node. And now I'm going to select a Slack request node. And again, launch connected discovery. Specify my policy project. Launch the connected discovery wizard. And for this, I want to say that I want to send a message to a channel. And I need to specify the channel that I want to send a message to. So I'll select the channel demo the new node in ACE and click save. And finally, I'm going to use the transformation node to map between the two schemas. So I'll use a mapping node. And in the mapping node for the input schema, I'm going to use the response from the Salesforce input node. And for the output map, I'm going to use the request schema for the Slack request node. And for this demo, I'm going to just use the concat function to specify that new account has been created. So I'll put some text to new Salesforce account created or click OK there, and now specify name be used in the concat and save that. And wire up nodes and save that. So now I can start my test server. I can deploy my policy project, which contains the policies for Salesforce and Slack. That has been deployed successfully. And now I can use the flow exerciser to deploy the application containing the message flow to the integration server. And now the flow is ready to receive messages. So I'm going to create a new account in Salesforce. And this will cause a message to be sent to the message flow, which will then send a message to Slack. So let's put my name in here and can put some details here, like Winchester and UK. So if I save this, immediately a message has been sent to Slack. It says new Salesforce account created for Sanjay Nagchowdhury. And if I click on the view path button in the flow exerciser, I can see my name, Sanjay Nagchowdhury, has been specified, billing city Winchester and the country UK. And that's been transformed by the mapping node. And this message has been sent to Slack, which says a new Salesforce account created for Sanjay Nagchowdhury. And I can see the message in the Slack channel. So in this video, I've demonstrated the new Salesforce input node, which can receive a message from Salesforce. It can be processed. And in this example, I transformed the message and sent it to a Slack channel using the Slack request node.